Hi, I'm Stephen. Welcome to CT Films. Welcome to the E3 wrap-up with good friends DVT. And I'll be going through the Microsoft conference that just finished a couple of minutes ago. And this is my second take because I'm stuttering most of the time. So in case I'm stuttering, then sorry about that. Anyways, let's get on with it. And I'll be doing it on the notepad, then the iPod Touch, because it's easier to write things down than doing it on the iPod Touch like I normally do on my vlogs. Anyways, first off, they showed off some Call of Duty Black Ops gameplay, and also they'll be releasing their maps exclusively to Xbox 360 first, and they'll be doing it from 2010 to 2012, because Xbox 360 partnered with Activision to get all their maps exclusively on Xbox. No PS3 fanboys out there should know about that now, sorry to say. Sorry, especially CC fanboys, sorry. Anyways, also the Project Natal has confirmed their latest new name called Kinect. So connecting, isn't it? Alright, sorry, rubbish punchline, sorry. Fails, DVT. Anyways, so they announced their name called Kinect. I know it sounds a bit awkward because it's how it's spelt, and it's actually pronounced and saying Kinect. It's weird. Anyways, also they showed some Metal Gear Solid Rising trailer, and they showed the mechanic, which is the cutting mechanic with Raiden's sword, which is really, really interesting with the cutting technology and all that. Also, Cliff, the good old Cliff that makes Gears of War games, have just showed off some gameplay of Gears of War 3 with 4-player co-op. Except for they didn't do it split screen, it's just that they show Cliff's side playing Gears of War 3. And Cliff has announced a new mode called Beast. Sounds interesting. And good old Fable 3. You know, we here in the UK created the whole Fable franchise. Is going to make sorry about that. Basically they just announced Fable 3, which will be coming, the date I'm just saying, that's coming out October 26 worldwide, because it's a worldwide date because it's on a Tuesday here in the UK and normally we get our games on Friday. Bit of a mixed concept. Anyways, also they got this new exclusive Xbox 360 game which has Gladiator Spartans or something, and it's called Codename Kingdom. I might have said it wrong, sorry. But it's called Codename Kingdom, I think it's called. Sorry, I was like, what? Spartans? What's this Xbox 360 exclusive? And all that. Weird. Anyways, also the major Xbox 360 exclusive that I cannot wait for, because I enjoyed the beta and I can't wait for it, and that is Halo Reach. They showed off the campaign gameplay, and it's really, really interesting. And it's just really interesting because I love Halo and Halo and all that. I know being fanboyish, but I just love Halo. Anyways, also they showed off some stuff with using Kinect on Zoom, and it sounds interesting. It's like Xbox pause, Xbox play. It sounds really interesting. I could just command my Xbox and ask it to make a sandwich. Wish I can do that to a woman. Anyways, sorry for being sexist. Right. Anyway, so yeah, controlling Zoom with Kinect. And also with Kinect, you can also video call conversations. So there goes the whole having the Xbox Live Vision camera, which is sadly to say, so you can do all that on Kinect now. And the feature will not only be for Xbox, but for all your Windows Live Messages or MSN people, you can also get that feature and connect with your Xbox 360 friends. Very interesting. Sorry, I never go on MSN much because there's not much people to talk to, but something on the lines there, that'll be interesting. Also in America, there's this thing called ESPN. I do not know, it's some kind of US sports website thingy. And basically they were showing off the thing where you can actually stream and watch content of sports, of NBA, soccer, or as you like to call it, soccer, we call it football, and very interesting, you know, football stuff. And also it's free for gold members only. God, you need all that gold, you know. Anyways, Also with Kinect, they got some really cool exclusive titles. One of them is Kinect Mammals, which is where you can interact with a pet. And it sounds really interesting because this little girl came up on stage and she was dead little and she was like, come here, come here. It's really interesting. But my little, I can tell you this now, even though I've got iPet, but to be honest, that would be really interesting for my sister because I've got a baby sister and she would love that game. That's all I can say. Also with Kinect, they also have Kinect Sports, which is a rip-off of Wii Sports sort of thing, I guess. Also with Kinect Adventures, which utilises the camera, and every time you do like a pose, it takes a photo and it just does all the magical moments, and also you can upload them photos onto Facebook, which is kind of interesting. Finally, we get the feature we can upload photos onto Facebook with Xbox. Sounds interesting. Also, Kinect Joyride, which utilises driving, which is really interesting. You boost by doing that, which is really cool. And I think you drift by really tilting by its side or something, which is really, really cool. And also, Ubisoft has an exclusive Kinect title, which is Your Shape Fitness Evolution, which is a really cool, interesting yoga and other types of fitness regime that I don't know much about, only my mum would know. And I think my mum would enjoy that, even though I've got Wii Fit, but what can you do? Also, Harmonix, the creators who did Rock Band, have done this thing called Dance Center, where you have to pull off really cool moves, and they're actual moves from choreographers from different sorts of dance regime. Some songs I might know about, but know the choreography. But overall, sounds really interesting that Harmonix is doing with choreography. Choreography? Sorry, I'm not with it today. You know, the whole choreography sound. Talking gibberish. Anyways, also the whole Kinect regime is it worldwide? I haven't even checked the calendar. I think that's a worldwide date. But it says, he said North America at November 4th. Is November 4th a Tuesday or? If it's worldwide, then it'll be on a Tuesday if it's November 4th. I haven't checked the calendar on my iPod, sorry, I'm being lazy. I should really do that. Sorry about that. Also with Kinect, you can also do the one and only famous Star Wars, and you can actually lightsaber stuff. Because the gameplay on the trailer, because all they did was the trailer, and the gameplay trailer looks really interesting. You just stand there with your lightsaber and you just do this and that, you can force push. And the whole moving to one step beyond is by like doing this or something. I know I look like I'm thrusting, but it's actually like thrusting to the next part of the land. Because you have to, how are you going to move them out with Kinect? You know, move about in free roam in sandbox games. That'll be quite confusing with Kinect. Sorry, I'm just saying. But sounds really interesting though. Anyways, also they showed off saying about walking about. You can just walk about this and that way and this and that way. And that is looking at really posh cars from Forza. Now they haven't announced like a Forza 4 or anything like that. But basically, the whole thing with Kinect and Forza, you can really interact with your cars, going in the cars, and also you can touch and it gives you information, and you can walk around, and it's really, really interesting. Also not only that, you can actually drive with the cars, and the person that did the gameplay, and they showed us some gameplay, and they didn't announce if it was Forza 4, but it should be Forza 4, but basically, he really good driving on that gameplay sort of thing. And also, to finally finish off this video, they announced a Xbox 360 Slim, which was kind of leaked yesterday, or it's already now, but there is an Xbox 360 Slim, and guess what? It comes out today, this week, some point, because it comes out today in some places, but overall it'll be coming out everywhere this week, and it looks interesting. Even though it's got built-in Wi-Fi, and they said it's the best Wi-Fi even though I do have a Wi-Fi adapter, but somehow lost. But I'm quite happy with my original Xbox, to be honest. Even though it's slightly dying because the disc drive is dying because I had it for like 2 years old. maybe purchase in the next couple of years. But sounds really interesting, an Xbox 360 Slim for all you new Xbox 360 comers, which really, really cool. But overall, it's built ready with the maybe a new dashboard, and also ready to use Natal Kinect already. So that is my E3 wrap up of the Microsoft conference. Do tune in tomorrow and subscribe for the Nintendo and Sony. Hope you enjoyed this video. See you from CT Films.